Hi friends, good evening one and all. I welcome you all to this technology update meeting on the topic recognizing of deep fake images using frequency analysis. Myself Rupesh Kumar, working as an associate professor in EC department. The topic which you are going to see today is most necessary in during this COVID situation, since we could not able to see each and every person individually directly. There are more number of chances to occur a intruder may be involved in our transactions or even our operations, whatever we do, either it may be as a banking transactions or maybe some communication, whatever we want to share. There may be a chances where intruder can able to be involved inside. So to avoid or how to identify this deep fake images, we are going to use an algorithm which is called as a discrete cosine transform. That is the thing which you are going to see in this topic. It's called as deep fake images. So as we have been mentioned, what is the necessary to identify which is an original image and which is an image which is being created by an intruder? To identify this thing only, we go for a topic that is called as deep fake image. That is, as we have been said, to protect our belonging. As the name itself indicates, so why it is called as deep fake image? How these images have been created? So we know that the machine learning algorithms plays a major important role where we used to train with the help of more number of neural networks. Such things we have to be training so that the machine can able to be do whatever the human involvement are being doing at a very faster process or faster rate. And the same thing, the drawback, where with the help of some deep learning algorithms, the systems will be generating a more number of random images. With the help of this random images, it comes for a conclusion whether it has been as original images, like such a random image will be creating. And a person who has been having not that much knowledge or who could not able to identify whether it is an original image or a fake image, he will not be having a knowledge and he may be thinking that the fake image has been an original image. To identify this thing or how to rectify it, for that only we saw this topic. That's what is called as a deep learning, is called as a machine learning, which has been derived from that word, and that fake are being generated from the computer models. These things are also called as a generative adversarial network. So how this deep fake image has been produced? Generally, we create a random images based on some input data. After creating this random images, that we are been checking, that intruder will be checking whether the image which has been created, it is a fake or it is a real image. So once, if it has been, the iteration will be followed until it has been identified whether it is an original image or it has been as a fake image. Once it has been identified, it is an original image, then the process is going to be stopped until that it goes on. Whether this method which you are going to see now, it is a new thing or any other methods are being available previous times, yes, it has been available, but they all involve a complex technique. Whereas this frequency analysis, where the images are going to be converted into a more number of discrete cosine transform, that is called as a DCT technique. So which we have been seen in our digital image processing technique, where the DCT plays a major important role. Once these images are going to be converted into more number of individual portion, from there it was going to be summed up. So how it is going to be identified whether it is a original image or it is going to be as a fake image? It can able to be identified with the help of a frequency components which is going to be present inside. If it's going to be a natural image, the frequency components are will be having a low frequency. If it's going to be as the image which has been created by a computer or by an intruder, or in general we call it as GA images, they all will be having a high frequency component. Therefore, frequency analysis is a more effective way to recognize whether it is system generated images or it has been as original image. So even when we visualize in the site that is called as whichfaceisreal.com, we can able to identify whether the images, whatever we follow, it is a original image or it is being as a fake image. Hope we'll be meeting you all, everybody, soon after this COVID-19. Let us wish we all the best. Thank you.